One of the things that we do on a Coyote block for prep is we basically we cut all the flash, casting flash away. You see I've already hit the top of that. But to show you how bad these can be, check this out here. You see this, sorry, this lip right there. Look at how big that thing is. I'm gonna go through with a sand roll and just deburr that. The oil drains as well down in there a little bit here. It's a little bit harder to see, but these got some burrs around them as well that we clean up. You know, this is a brand new block, fresh out of the box. I checked piston the wall with the Manleys. That this thing is getting a Manley piston. Manley would like a 3.5. I usually, this being a blower motor, I usually run them a little bit looser than that, 3/10, 4/10. This is half thou big already, so we're gonna have 4 thou piston to wall, which is plenty acceptable. But yeah, just thought I'd show you guys the casting flash that will be removed. There's a lot of little stuff too, like around the oil port there, you see that. I'll go through all this with a sand roll and just clean it up so it's nice and there's nothing that's gonna potentially, you know, break off and cause an issue down the road. But yeah, just thought I'd show you guys that before I get too deep into the assembly process of this. We're gonna get this deburred and pull the main caps off of it, clean it up, brush all the oil galleys, and get it on a stand and start file fitting rings. So. Alright, got the engine back on a stand after we did the deburring and the cleaning. The next step is gonna be the file fit piston rings. I wanted to give you a quick overview on the oiling system since I don't show really our cleaning process. Basically, once it's, you know, in a used block, once you get all the big stuff knocked off of it, we put it in a, before assembly, put it in a mineral spirits tank, excuse me, and then we'll brush all of the oil galleys. In order to do that correctly, you need to have a decent understanding of the oiling system. So I wanted to give you a quick overview on the Coyote oiling system. So it is a crankshaft-driven oil pump. It'll just sit here. It seals against this. That port there goes directly, into here to feed the oil filter, through the filter back into this. That then feeds the main galley, which is here, and you can see it in the casting. You see that there going to this main galley. This here feeds the passenger side cylinder head. And this on the one that you can't see in here goes, this is the oil feed for the driver's side cylinder head. So when you're cleaning these, you gotta make sure you brush all that. I'm gonna roll this thing over a quick second here. Okay, so again, that's the main oil galley here that I do not have a plug in currently. It goes all the way through the bottom here. So if this is the oil squirters from the Coyotes. And then all of the main oiling comes right off that main galley as well, right? Another interesting thing to note is that's the oil pressure side. So the drain side, this is part of the oil drain. And being that this is above the crankshaft, I consider that more of a crankcase vent, or basically where way to get crankcase pressure back into the valve cover area as opposed to an oil drain. These here are also oil drains. These are from the lower side of the cylinder head. These ones along the pan rail. And these ones there are from the top side of the cylinder head. I'll explain that a little bit better once I roll the block back over. Okay, now you see that cylinder head oil feed there. So this is the bottom set of drains that comes out by the pan rail. Obviously, gravity is naturally going to cause the oil to all pretty much all drift down to here. Now, when the engine's running, it's pretty chaotic. Oil's going everywhere. This is the other set of drains on the top. And these go into this cavity here, which on the underside, I just showed you those oval-shaped holes at the underside of that cavity. Now, what I like about that is it allows the crankcase pressure and anything that's getting by the piston rings to have a decently unobstructed way to evac back into the valve covers. What I mean by unobstructed is there usually isn't going to be oil, or at least a lesser amount of oil, going into these top drains than in the bottom ones. If it only had the bottom ones, it would be pushing air up where the oil is trying to come down, which is going to cause oil drain back problems. Having it here allows the air to escape back to the valve cover without slowing the drain from the cylinder head back to the crankcase. So I'm gonna get going on file fitting rings. I don't think I'm gonna do a video of that, but I'm gonna get those all done and set up, and then probably show you, just run through checking piston pin clearance on the connecting rod before we hang the pistons and get ready to put this thing together.